Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue the streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Happy Tuesday, everybody. Thank you all very much. That like streak counter keeps on trucking. Pretty amazing. We are already well on our way to the cashless week. Looking forward to it. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Braxton831. I think I'm saying that correctly. Yes, indeed. Other subreddits, we all know how they be mean to each other, but not this Evicta subreddit. It's all about memes, all about love, positivity, all that kind of stuff. And it's truly remarkable. The mosh pit knows no boundaries in terms of where we can just spread good vibes and good cheer to everybody. Like Christmas, only better. Today is going to be Hotel Whiskey X-Ray 8, Mike X-Ray 6-2. We've got Tech Zero and Mom's Box of Stuff. Oh boy, good damage. Oh, Curse the Blind, 2 sack of pennies. Probably should have thought twice about taking that, to be honest. That could have proven very badly. Although, I will say, wow, thank you for the wax soul heart. I will say that if we did end up getting Dunce Cap there, this is one of the few situations where like Dunce Cap would actually be incredible. With Tech Zero. Tech Zero is going to create a kind of like an energy beam lightning bolt. I'm not exactly sure what you would call it. It's just a laser beam that deals a pretty decent amount of damage. I can't believe we took damage in this room. Between your shots and the next consecutive shot. So it will always chain together with back-to-back shots via this lightning bolt tether thing. Get a bomb and a key instead of like a soul heart, and that's fine, I suppose. There was an excellent post. Actually, let me excuse the alt tab real quick, because there's an excellent post on the subreddit that somebody pointed out how to find secret rooms and super secret rooms, like where to know where to bomb. Okay, well, their name, of course, is nothing but barcodes. I try to be nice. I try to give someone credit, and their name is a freaking bunch of barcodes. Look. I can understand you trying to hide your identity in terms of like StarCraft or League of Legends or, you know, esports. That thing I understand. But like on Reddit, unless you're posting some really salacious stuff out there, it's hard for people to give you credit. Anyway, Barcode posted an excellent diagram on how to determine where to bomb for the secret rooms and super secret rooms in Isaac. And it actually makes a lot of sense. And it's something that I wish I had even thought about. You would think by now, with the amount of hours and the amount of episodes and just, you know, overall just experience that I have in this freaking game, that I would have determined what is the best way to do this. And we are. But the diagram makes a lot of sense. So essentially, if we get to an XL room, which I'm sure we will eventually, I'll take prayer bead. Actually, no, or the rosary bead, but I won't because I actually don't want I don't want an angel deal. I'll take the rusted key instead. What is this? Ansos. Essentially, you just scroll the camera all the way to the right, and then you just treat it as if that was a single room instead of an XL room, and bomb in the middle of the screen. That's it. It's that simple. So you essentially artificially cut off half of the room. We're gonna get hit over here. I don't like it. There's a bomb over here, or there's a tinted rock, I should say. Really hoping we were going to get a soul heart out of there, but we just don't do that. Oh, and it's a trinket too, and we got hit anyway. Hooray. But yeah, it's a really elegant way of handling that problem. So I should never really have a problem with knowing where to place the bomb at any point. I don't want Batwing though. Thank you. I am happy that we're going to get a cube of meat here. We also get a soul heart. We'll head on down. It's a very good start. Curse the Lost. Nice answers, rune nerd. Happy birthday to Alexa, I'm told. Not the Amazon Alexa, but her name is Alexa. Happy birthday, Alexa. Thank you very much for supporting the channel for so long. One correction that I just did because I was an autopilot at that point, but I called blood clot chemical peel. I vaguely remember telling myself in my brain while I was doing the commentary for that particular part, reminding myself like this isn't blood clot or this isn't chemical peel, but I'm just gonna call it that because I'm just in autopilot mode. But yeah, people losing their freaking minds because I didn't call them blood clot. Instead, I called it chemical peel. When my brain goes into autopilot mode and, you know, I do stuff like that, it's nothing to freak out about. I try to tell people that. It's like, look, if there's something completely obvious, obviously I meant something else when I said it. It's not like I say anything controversial. I just had a brain fart and just was like, oh, yeah. You know, we're going to avoid chemical peel here when it's actually, you know, blood clot. That's going to happen. Call that caster mishaps. There's a large possibility of that happening the more one that we are on a run. Like this run right now, it's not one run status yet, but if we get like one or two damage upgrades and a couple of tiers ups, dude, we're rolling in it. Gonna hold on to the flat penny. Flat penny is going to give us an opportunity to get a key every time that we pick up a coin. And I believe that mom's box of stuff does increase that. It doubles it, maybe. I'm not sure if it doubles it or not. But while we're holding on to mom's box of stuff here, and it's actually not even the technical term is, I believe, just I think it's just mom's box. But when we're holding on to it, it doubles the trinket effect of anything that we're holding. So I don't know if that translates to double the chance of us getting a payout or not, or if it just activates twice. I'm not sure. So far, we're 1 for 2, so, yeah, it's 50-50. Now, of course, with Tech Zero, we want to get piercing shots if possible. Piercing shots are amazing to have. Lazy Worm and Monkey Paw probably won't. I hope I don't need it either. Okay, so this is what Barcode was talking about. So here we are. We find ourselves in an XL room, and I think, man, I think that the secret room is going to be in here somewhere. Where do we go? If I just take this... Picture this. Let me show you my mouse cursor real quick. Give me a second here. I don't normally show the mouse cursor on Isaac just because obviously like that would get pretty annoying. Can you see it here? No, you can't. Maybe if I transition it that way, can you see my mouse cursor? You still can't see it. Okay, well, I'll go to the display capture then. How about that? By the way, you're not gonna be able to see the difference here. Excuse me. Display capture. Are you there? Okay, there you go. All right, you see my mouse cursor. Good. Okay, that took a while there. Sorry. Or it's gonna turn off again, dude. OBS. See, this is what I'm talking about. With OBS. Welcome to OBS Studio, everyone. Okay. All right. You see my mouse cursor. Okay. Good. All right. So, picture this being the Some people were explaining where they were expressing confusion over what the diagram meant. And I'm trying to alleviate that concern and also explain. So picture this as being, we're just in a single one by one room, just a regular old room in Isaac. When you move the camera all the way where you can see the borders of the furthest wall horizontally, that is where you could imagine this is where the room is. So picture this being a one by one room. That means if I wanted to check where the secret room was in this particular room, I would have to just place it like a normal secret room bomb would be, which would be right in the middle. You know, it would never be off to the side over here or over here like I always do because I've never really thought about this. But this is an elegant way of handling this problem. So when you're in an XL room, and by definition, an XL room is anything that's more than just a regular room, a one by one. You can scroll. You can just get Isaac to the point where you can just see the outer edge, the perimeter of the wall, and then just bomb in the middle of the screen. And that is where potentially, if there is a secret room there, that is where you can check it. And that's also where you are going to have the most success. Looking for those. So no longer will I have to worry about placing incorrect bombs in XL rooms because I know that, hey, the middle of the screen's right here. If it's there, cool. If not, no big deal. So, yeah. That took way longer of an explanation than it should have, but I just wanted to clear that up. See, that's why you shouldn't have barcodes as your name on Reddit. You gotta recognize how valuable you are, and if people want to give you credit for stuff, then you should let them. I'm not gonna say like I bar three bar I bar, you know, like I'm just gonna call you barcode. Pulling the freaking jukes over here. There we go. By the way, this room is excellent for those of you who are trying to learn how to dodge in Isaac. This is an excellent training tool in this room right here. So again, as another elegant demonstration of what barcode was showing, let's say that I don't think that the secret room's here, for example. I mean, I knew it was there because I know this room, but look, that's beside the point. If pretend that this bottom wall was clear, we would be totally in a room like this. So pretend that this one by one is this right here. Pretend that there's a wall on the right side. You would just simply bomb right in the middle as if this were just a single room like this. See? So like we wouldn't want to bomb here. We would bomb over here, like down below there, where the steel block is. Hopefully that's making sense. I think that now that I've explained it to people, in theory, anyway, it should make more sense. And if not, then, well, I don't know what to tell you. Ask barcode. Been a lot of fourth wall breaking on this episode so far. But, like, I normally wouldn't even spend all that much time to address something like that, except that it is such a great tip, and I think it is a very valuable piece of information, useful information that players new and old can experience and learn from. So I'm 100% with you on that. Have we already found the secret room? I don't even know anymore. I think I have. No, we haven't. It's right here. How'd you know there's Invicta? Well, I just know stuff. Jimmy. When you get to be this experienced at the game, when you're this important, you just kind of know everything, okay? I'd be the worst. I'd be the worst if I was like that. Luckily, I'm not like that. Flat Penny coming up with the big-time plays, getting us all these keys. You had your chance. Crooked Penny, we're done. Me and you, we're finished. I could go get a bomb and we could access that. We could access the Book of Secrets. I don't really care about it, to be honest, because I'm not going to not keep Mom's box here just because I want the Cancer Trinket or the Crack Crown. And we've already proven that Crack Crown is much better with the box than the Cancer Trinket is. All right, now that we've got all the explanations out of the way, we can get back down to business. I can't believe that shot hit us. I saw it was a sad but hilarious clip on the subreddit yesterday. Today for me, but yesterday for you all. It's weird how we have that jumping timeline, isn't it? Trust me, it's weird to me as well. Having to speak in the past tense, even though it's present tense for me. Anyway, but there was a sad but kind of funny post on the subreddit. Someone had lost their 11 Eden streak by way of the metronome, because it actually procced remote control. By remote control, I mean it procced a clicker. And it turned him from Eden to the Lost. And unfortunately, when you have that happen, you do not gain the Holy Mantle, nor do you gain the D4 with the metronome. And he just dies, unfortunately. He or she just dies on Mega Mall. It was inside of a boss trap room. So that, honestly, like that's another piece of valuable information for me to realize, is that metronome can indeed give you the clicker. And that would be one terrifying and traumatic way to lose an Eden streak. But I definitely feel your pain. And it brings new insight to my love of metronome. I probably have gotten lucky over the last couple of runs that we've had metronome, but I never, ever would want to get clickered. Clickered? I think that should be a verb. If it's not already, hopefully it doesn't mean anything terrible. You saw that champion skitterer try to take the quick cut on us. Cuban meat was too fast. So you want to try to get to the nubs before they spawn anything. Of course, we got to deal with the spiders as well as the flies. Second hand. There's no real reason for me to go into a dice room. And we should go into the... We should go into the secret room from this side because we don't have enough bombs to go through. We don't have two bombs to make it our to make all the way through from one side to the other of the wall. We really, really could benefit from some movement speed, shot speed, of course, and tears rate. More damage is always going to be nice as well. I am encouraged by the fact that we did get Guppy's head from our first devil deal. Because if we get Guppy's tail, we can actually hold on to it for... I mean, it's not as detrimental as it has been in the past because of the fact we have Flat Penny. Of course, that being said, Flat Penny is going to get yeeted to the stratosphere as soon as we get Crack Crown or Cancer. Unless if we decide to get rid of... The reason why I didn't want to get Void is because, A, we just got done having Void not that long ago. And, B, I want to have the double effect of our trinket slots. Halo Flies, excellent item. It's going to give us two orbitals. Now, what I really should do is I shouldn't pick up any money until I come back and I'm holding the Flat Penny. The only reason why I picked up the safety scissors here is because maybe we can get lucky and get another troll bomb or two. It will convert all troll bombs into regular bombs. It would also completely negate, as you see right there, also completely negate the downside of sack of bombs. But, bomb bag is what I meant, but I'm not going to do that. I will bomb, however, the key beggar, and we'll get some coins, pick it up. I know, I should have gone back to get the Flat Penny, but who's got that kind of time? Not me. I'm an important YouTuber and streamer. Really not that important. And we'll get another soul heart here. We could, in theory, take school bag. This would be the one time where it would make sense. But I'm still not going to do it. I know. Just take school bags and Victor Gar. Look, I'm set in my ways sometimes, you know? It's just the micro that... school bag requires you to do if in order for you, especially if you're trying to align like blank card and other cards or stuff like that, it can be real annoying. There is literally no downside to school bag. I want to make sure that I'm clear on that. And this is something I always feel the need that like I have to defend myself in these opinionated cases. But there is absolutely no reason for you not to take school bag. Unless if you're like me and I'm just lazy and I don't feel like dealing with the micro. That is quite literally the only reason why I don't take it. And I know it's a terrible excuse. I know it's not a good way to play, but you know, I do not encourage people to do that. That's just my own personal beef. And who doesn't like beef, you know? I guess vegetarians probably don't. Cows probably don't either. It'd be a little messed up to feed a cow beef. I do love me some steak though, man. Like it's just steak is just. And I'm still, despite everything that I don't remember what episode we were talking about, Impossible Burgers and whatnot, but like I'm still like 100% fine with trying an Impossible Burger or Beyond Burger. I mean, like I like knowing that there's alternatives and stuff like that out there. That's really good knowledge. You know, and then you gotta, of course, as a consumer, you have to be very wary of, like, you know, the propaganda going against each other. Like, you know, some people start saying, well, actually, Impossible Burger is worse for the environment because of this and this and this. The cows are actually healthier for the environment. And then it's like, oh, well, actually, the cows are doing this and this, and they're creating, you know, super cows and that. Like, you know, you gotta be careful of that. Very happy to have Sack Dagger, of course. Never not happy to have Sack Dagger. I have to try when I get the house, that one of the first things I'm going to do is I'm going to buy a sous vide machine. Cool. I'm not sure what exactly you call it. I just know it as sous vide. Because there's a very large and popular channel here on YouTube called I think it's called Guga Foods. And it's essentially just a steak channel. They experiment with meat, grilling, all kinds of stuff. It's not just primarily steak. It's a lot of beef. And they do all kinds of really awesome and interesting videos. And one of the ones that I saw was they were doing Wagyu and like all the different ways that you can have Wagyu. Now, I'm such a huge steak fan. You'd think that I would have had actual Wagyu at any stage of my life. The answer is no. I've never actually tasted Wagyu, not even the Australian version, the Japanese, the original version. I've never had that ever. But whenever you put Wagyu in a video and you're a known cookie channel, of course people are going to flock to that video. And one of the videos that they did for Wagyu was like what's the best way to actually enjoy it. They got like a really expensive cut, a sirloin from Japan that was imported. And one of the ways that they did it was a traditional Japanese way, which I've seen done before, but I didn't know how they did it. But they had essentially you pasteurize an egg, a whole egg, in a sous vide machine. And then you just take the yolk, you get rid of the egg white, you take the egg yolk and you dip the steak in it after it's done cooking and stuff. And apparently it's like the bomb. Like it is the ultimate way to eat steak. And I'm just like, man, I've got to try that. It looks so good. Now, of course, steak and eggs and all that kind of good stuff. I'm sure some of you probably are aware of the video I'm talking about. It's got millions of views. I mean, they're a popular channel. They do a very good job with production and everything. I love watching their stuff. I just want to try it. It just looks good. You know, those of you who are out there in the mosh pit and who are chefs and whatnot, let me know if there's a better way to do the egg at home sort of way instead of using a sous vide machine. Cause I currently don't own one and I'm not going to buy one until I've got my own kitchen and everything. I'm just intrigued because I heard it is the ultimate way to experience like top quality beef. Now down here in Texas, I'm not exactly sure what the best way is to obtain Wagyu, like actual certified Wagyu beef. I don't really believe restaurants anymore. After being a waiter for so long, I'm kind of like, by the way, yes, credit card, greed fight, yes, thank you. I'm not saying all restaurants are liars, but I just, for me, like, I'm very picky when it comes to, like, a super high-end place to go eat. We don't have a bomb. Super secret room's right there, and we don't have a bomb. We have no way of getting in. I should have probably held on to the safety scissors at this point. And a Nine Tails is excellent for two reasons. It's a great damage up, and secondly, that shot speed. Mm-mm. I definitely want to try it though. Like that's something that I will do before I bite the big one. I will eat authentic Japanese Wagyu beef, like Kobe beef and stuff. And I also will own a sous vide machine so I can actually do the whole egg and steak thing. That's a great video because neither one of them were neither one of the guys who were doing the show thought that they would like the egg. They thought like, you know, it's just like it's a kind of like a trend or whatever. But both of them in the end, both of them picked the egg as their favorite way. They did it with the egg, they did it just by itself, and they also did it with like rice. Like just straight up like sticky rice and stuff. And the rice also looked really good, but man, like that egg just looked I wanna just imagine the texture on that, you know. I mean, say what you want about BuzzFeed and stuff, but they're one of the I'm not subscribed to them, but I do try to watch some of their videos. Like BuzzFeed is like the perfect channel, like when you're bored and trying to like go to bed at night. Another greed fight. Nice store credit, nerd. That's fun. Hey, we finally got some bombs here. Whipworm. Whipworm's actually incredible for Tech Zero. We just get the soul heart. I don't care about, I really don't care about, store credit anymore. Especially now that we're like, you know, one shop away from having no more shops. Deadeye, of course, was a huge pickup for us with Tech Zero. The shot speed is just incredible. I have some bucket list things I'd like to do. Now, I'm not that old, but you know, I feel like I'm getting up there soon. When I get to 30, that's when I'll start feeling like real old. But there's some things that I want to do. I definitely want to. The biggest one is involving traveling, and I'm not someone who likes to travel. I think we've already been over that. I'm a homebody, man. Like I want to stay home. I want to work. I want to, you know, just relax in my own place. I don't want to go travel and just, you know, it doesn't feel right to me. You know, I'm not accustomed to it. But that being said, I definitely want to go to Iceland at least one time before I die, and Japan for sure. Japan would be the priority in those two locations. Nothing against Iceland, of course, but I would love to go visit Japan. I think that would be a life-changing experience. I'm not at all interested in going to China. You know, with me being Chinese, I don't know. There's to me, like, I've never really been too compelled to explore that side of my heritage. Let's put it this way: I'd much prefer to go to Ireland first before I go to China. That's just the God's honest truth right there. You can't be mad at me for being honest. And a Krampus fight. Lava coal is also a nice upgrade here. But, you know, sure would like to find our item room. Them old Driscoll boys have been getting our item rooms all mixed up. Arthur was getting a little Uncle Deckard there for a moment. Stay a while. Listen to the old Driscolls. Leia old Driscoll. That's not her last name, Uncle Deckard. Where I'm going there. We have fairy bombs, which we've been needing bombs, but I want stats more at this point. Sad onion is good enough. It's going to get us almost to the tiers cap, but more importantly, it's going to really make our damage pop off whenever we eventually do get crack crown. When that's going to be, I don't know. Get a golden bomb here. Stepping out, stepping back, so my brain stops breaking in that room. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know where the secret room is. Can't be to the left of here. Super secret room, or actually regular secret room could be up here. That'd be a weird spot. Could also be here, also a weird spot. But I guess we'll never find out. And Curse the Blind on our final shot. Yep. That good old trolling Isaac. Hey, a soul heart. Fancy that. This is definitely a run that I'm not going to be taking a blind item, so just as a quick word of warning to those of you who were super duper triggered about it by the last time I skipped an item room without saying anything. I will not be going to an item room, although with this black rune I probably will be going into an item room just to get the stats from it. But as far as taking blind items are concerned, unless it's at the very beginning of a run, I no longer take item room blind items anymore. And the reasoning behind it is just because I do not want to get something bad like experimental treatment where it nukes all of our good stuff. It's possible it could be good, but it's equally possible that it could be bad. So I would rather eliminate the possibility of getting screwed by the game by simply just saying, yeah, we don't take blind items anymore. Now this could be Guppy's Tail. Could also be Cursed Eye. And says, okay. I'm hoping that we get a Degas rune so we can actually see what that item is. And with us having Mystery Sack, it is possible. Okay, so this is a perfect opportunity. We know the secret room is here. Okay. So if we have our camera all the way over to the left and to the top, we can see at least two walls. We can treat this entire scene with the perimeter of the room being right underneath this spot down here. Pretend that this is the bottom of our make-believe room. Then all I have to do is bomb in the middle of this room to find out where the secret room is. Normally, I'd be placing a bomb here. I'd be placing a bomb over here. I'd be like, oh my god, I can never figure it out. I'm just going to go to the other place. Well, now all you gotta do is just bomb right in the middle of this room, and you will always hit the secret room. So, you know, it's an absolutely outstanding way to explain how to find secret rooms. And it was diagrammed very well. Wasn't necessarily explained very well in text, but now that I've explained it and shown it to you all, go forth. And I give all credit to the person known as Barcode on subreddit. Get damage upgrade and more shot speed. Oh boy. I know, it's killing you inside. You want to know what's in that red chest. I do too. But if we get Cursed Eye, your boy ain't going to be happy. At all. Like, at all. Wow, thank you, Lipstick. You know what? I'm getting this soul heart, even if it costs me all of them. Mom's Key, excellent. Golden Horseshoe is completely worthless. King Baby's terrible. Mom's Bottle of Pills is certainly an item that exists in the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. Starter deck is awesome. Strength card is cool. Justice is also cool. Looking for Black Kenadu. Spider mod. Second Steam sale would also be cool. A little baggy. Thank you very much. Rip all of our cards and rune hopes. Pay to play. Blue map. All right. Piggy bank and compost. Hooray. Oh, there we go. I could use the dice shard in here. You know what? Why not? Data peeler and nightlight. So I guess I can go back and go pick up that blind item for the cursed on the cursed chest, because even if it's Cursed Eye, I can just use Sack Dagger for DPS. And to be honest, Cursed Eye isn't Cursed Eye isn't that terrible with Tech Zero. It's just terrible just because it's Cursed Eye. But we can curse the tower, so that should be interesting. Too bad we don't have a shame that we don't have the safety scissors anymore. Although having Curse of the Tower will allow us to do something like this. Yeah, that was totally worth it. Spend two soul hearts to get one. Wonderful. So you're seeing what I'm talking about here with this maximum tech zero shot speed and everything. It is just a thing of beauty. Take Blank Rune. I will take that. Oh, boy. I'm hoping for Degas or... Alges. We'll just get back-to-back Alges runes. AWAS. We gotta take one here. Hey, Pentagram, you know what? I'm fine with that. Could have been worse. Now, that being said, we do have to be careful on this level, especially with us not having our Polaroid invincibility. We need to be extremely careful. Stars card. I'm actually surprised we haven't gotten that many bombs in this run. The Tendon Rock in here that we do not have access to. Now we have access to it. Okay. We'll do this just because. Got Stars card. Stars card is going to take us somewhere random. Since there's no item room to travel to on this floor, it's just going to take us to a random spot. Also, something I haven't mentioned yet about yesterday's run, but yes. I talked about it on stream tonight. The close call with Cage was extremely close. When it happened, it didn't register in my brain at the time just because I was just, I was in autopilot mode, and then all of a sudden I needed to get out of autopilot mode to not die in that room. But after rewatching it, after people were freaking out about it and saying how close it was, I went back and watched that fight, and man, it doesn't get any closer than that. I mean, we were clipping inside of Cage. I'm actually going to take both here only because I want 2020, the possibility of 2020 anyway from the bookworm. But I'm going to stick with Mom's Box because, again, breaking the tiers cap for this build is truly astounding. I said astounding, I meant outstanding. So you might be wondering, why are we still rolling for more trinkets? Well, there's always a possibility of us being able to hold a second trinket. I was kind of hoping that we were going to get Mom's purse in the store. Chariot card is certainly something. Yeah, so again, this is another perfect scenario here. All we have to go to is the middle of the screen. So we just look on this wall right over here. Where is the middle? If this were just a singular room, where would the middle of this room be? It would be right here. Okay, the camera shifted down on me a little bit. That right there is the result of us having way too much movement speed. So that right there is a good example of why I particularly do not care for movement speed above 1.65, 1.7 at the absolute max. Isaac gains this really weird momentum that can cause you to slide through like movements and stuff. And if you're not careful, or if you're just not paying attention, you can get thrown right on into like a spike hazard or a poop hazard, something like that. Gotta be careful. Kind of sad that we didn't get an opportunity to get any more guppy items? The Curse of the Blind really hurt, like, a lot. We have to make a decision now whether or not we want to use... Do we think we're going to get a devil deal on this floor? I'm going to say no. 36%. It's not worth giving up Polar Invincibility, my opinion. But we've already gotten rid of the Krampus tax, so if we do get one, you know, it's got to be premium for us to consider taking us down to 1 HP. And we didn't, so it was a good call. We'll head on up to the cathedral. Curse the Blind, who really cares at this point? Not me. Now, there's a reroll pedestal in here, which is interesting, because there's also a judgment in here. So... essentially, what we can do is we can create an item pedestal in here, and then we can reroll the item. But, of course, with this being a Curse of the Blind floor, we have no idea what that item's going to be until we've already picked it up. And it's kind of a crapshoot taking a blind item from Judgment, because it could be almost anything. Get the bean, okay. And something else I need to consider is the fact that we don't want an HP upgrade, so I probably shouldn't have just taken that all willy-nilly. Stick of butter. You gotta love butter, man. One of the things I'm looking forward to redoing the keto diet. Being able to use a lot of butter. You're always gonna, and even saying something like that, like, is always gonna trigger somebody to say, hey, by the way, don't do the ketogenic diet. It's terrible for you. You gotta do this and this and this and this and the blah 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 blah. Okay. For me personally, I do my homework on stuff before I consider like changing diets and whatnot. And all I know is I was only able to do keto for 2 weeks before I had to stop. And I only stopped because I wasn't able to cook what I needed to or wanted to anymore, due to my dad. I got to cook a lot of beef, a lot of steak, and you know, just a lot of meat in general. And he doesn't really like, he's kind of sensitive to the smell of certain foods. I don't know why I did that. I could have used that on the next floor. But anyway, that's beside the point. I lost 13 pounds in the first 6 days of just doing keto, and I wasn't doing exercise either. That's the crazy thing. Even though most of it's water weight, obviously, it was still impressive. I was really impressed with how fast everything seemed to switch over. It only took my body about 48 hours to go fully from calorie burning to fat burning, or carb burning, I guess I should call it. And I was the biggest surprise, other than the weight loss, the biggest surprise for me was the fact that I was just not hungry at all. Like, I could go like if I was doing like a combination diet of intermittent fasting plus keto, dude, like, and if I was exercising correctly, like, I can see how the pounds would fly off very quickly. I've been lucky that my body is always super reactive to whatever I do. So, like, I can gain weight, and I can put on some pounds pretty quickly, but I can also shed it pretty easily. I was like, man, I could straight up just not eat today. Like, I'm not hungry. Like, I don't feel like eating today. the crazy thing is that, like, you're satisfied. Like, you feel like you've just eaten. It's the weirdest thing, man. It's hard to describe, but it was a good experience, and I look forward to experiencing that again. Oh, those are just... I mean, we could take Iron Bar just for the damage upgrade, but it's not even a full damage point of increase, so... And as always, as a disclaimer, I'm not a doctor. Don't take anything that I say word for word. I'm not a trained nutritionist. I'm not giving dietary advice or workout advice. It's sad that you gotta say stuff like that, but It's the world that we live in, unfortunately. Mongo baby, long time no see, bro. Good to see you. What an enjoyable run this has been, though. Tech Zero is truly a work of art. And when you combine it with the right items, especially with mom's box of stuff, you go far. Now let's ruin all of that. Oh, Lord. Oh, wait a second. But there's Cursed Eye over here. Oh, my Gertie. The dream combo. Big time plays. Making even bigger time plays. Oh, yes. Here we go. This is one of the few and only times a Cursed Eye is ever really, truly good. Oh, my good God. What just happened to this run, man? The D4, the D-Fizzle, hooking us up with Libra. I mean, D4 didn't give us Libra, but still. What in the world just happened to this run? We're going in the wrong direction. I don't even care. Actually, we're not going the wrong direction. Yeah, so this is Continuum Cursed Eye marked Libra. With the added benefit of the massive stat up that we're getting from holding mom's box of stuff with the cracked crown trinket. And I think we also have Proptosis. Oh, we doing it. Probably should have considered picking up the D4 just in case, but here we are. I mean, this is... Ooh, man, what's going to produce better results here? We have the D4 because of the school bag. That's hilarious. Surprisingly, Cracked Crown is not as good. Oh, wait, no, I take that back. We also have something that's allowing us to hold two trinkets. What is it? We have mom's purse. Wow. We D4'd into like the literal perfect thing for our build. Like, we D4'd into everything that I wish that we had. That's amazing. This run just got all kinds of crazy. So yeah, so anyway, with marked, I hate marked, but if you can somehow get Cursed Eye, this is the result that you get. You get essentially soy milk levels of tears rate because Cursed Eye has no cooldown and marked is making you fire nonstop. It's like having chocolate milk where you're just like you're hitting it as fast as possible. That's what marked is doing right now with Cursed Eye. And it's fantastic. Because you've got this like almost zero tier delay. It's absurd. Now you combine all those effects with the balance boosting or the stats boosting and balancing of Libra, and you've got yourself the making of something truly intense. I am gonna take Mom's Eye. Just F up my entire screen, fam. This is, I mean, we had a good run already for this build, but this just took it to a completely different level. We're taking it to, like, you know, sous vide egg yolk on Wagyu levels here of awesomeness. I'm gonna do that. One of these days, I'm gonna do that. And once I do, I'll let everybody know. I'm still going to be looking for the Cancer Trinket, though, because I think that that's going to give us more benefit than us having the Demon's Horn. Curved Horn, I mean. There's no way I'm going to be able to land a bomb in this thing. Absolutely no way. Not with the, not with Marked. But, I mean, who really needs to? Now, that being said, we do need to be slightly careful. I need to be mindful of incoming damage, obviously. Because we don't have polar invincibility. Little Brimmy, how you doing? Ooh, black feather, I don't know. So that's thinking 14. Wait, this is 19. That's 18. No, this is 23. Yeah, it's still better with Curved Horn and Crack Crown. I didn't think that Black Feather was going to give us that much more of a stat boost. I just wanted to be sure. And the fact that we have Mom's Eye is making a shot shoot behind us. So we have essentially a full screen of coverage here. Oh, here we go. Here we go, coach. Actually not better. .23.83, .15.97, .21.52. Yeah, technically speaking, Cancer is still not as good. I would not have thought that with Libra. Curved Horn is giving us more of a skew on our damage. It's giving more... Actually, no, you know what? That does actually make sense because we're already past the tiers cap. So technically speaking, the only thing that Cancer is giving us is just one more tiers rate. As opposed to four damage. So that makes sense. That makes sense as the reason why that Libra is bouncing out like that. Oh my goodness, it's Black Lotus. We're just seeing all the big-time players show up here for this finale of this run. I have no idea where I am. All right, still just looking for that Delirium fight. The search for Delirium has never been more enjoyable. And good luck if you can see what the heck's going on the screen, because I can't. Gonna be Stanley. How you doing, Stan? Stanley, you are not gonna have fun with this fight. I can tell you that right now, brother. This is a stream of purple, white, and black death. No, we don't care about BBF. Well, this has gotta be Delirium here. No, it's not. It's gonna be Skolex. Old Driscoll's been hiding our Delirium again. And in purest Invicta fashion, we go to every wrong way to go, except for the correct way at the final hallway. Let's go. Yep. Now, what would send this run over the top is if we got Magic Mush on top of all this. Yeah, we literally went to every boss room except the right one. As to be expected. Normally, I'd be a little bit concerned the fact that we don't have polar invincibility. I think that, as you can plainly see, we have really nothing to worry about in this fight at all. This is how you say super over. I just got Spoonbender here thanks to the Magician card. Yeah, we definitely have Proptosis somewhere. If I really wanted to, I could also D4 if we ever got in trouble. I'm just going to sit here and do this. I'm actually not even hitting Delirium with my forward-facing shots. That was actually all the tears you were seeing me hit right there with was what was coming out of the back of our head. This is just absurd. You got to love it. You gotta love it. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Let's get those likes up to, I don't know. I bet we could do 3 on this. Yeah. 3,000 likes? Sure. I bet the Mosh Pit can do it and beyond. Thank you again, everyone, for the support. Hope you had a great start to your Tuesday. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Don't worry, the tournament's coming soon. I promise you. I'll see you all next time.